on how to solve three-point linkage cross using four simple steps. With three genes, there are three possible crossover type or recombination that can take place. Let's take the example of two parents, capital ABC and small ABC type. A single crossover can happen between gene AB and genes BC, or a double crossover can happen between gene AB and BC. The recombinants obtained by a single crossover between genes A and B will be capital A, small b, small c, and small a, capital B, capital C. Similarly, a single crossover between genes B and C will give the recombinants as capital A, capital B, small c, and small a, small b, capital C. A double crossover between genes AB and BC will give the recombinant as capital A, small b, capital C, and small a, capital B, small c. In every question, we will have 8 type of gametes: 2 parental type, 2 single crossover type between gene 1 and 2, 2 single crossover types between gene 2 and 3, and 2 gametes for double crossover. It is very easy to identify the parental and the double crossover gametes in most of the questions. The gametes showing the highest number of progenies are the parental type, and the gametes showing the lowest number of progenies are the double crossover type. Let's look at this question where we need to find the distance between the genes and we are provided with the genotype and the number of observed progenies. To solve this, we must know the type of the gametes. So, our first step is to find the parental and the double crossover type. As we know, the highest number of progenies are the parental type and the lowest number of progenies are from the double crossovers. Now, the question mentions the genes as A, B and C, but the actual gene order can be different from A, B, C. To find the correct gene order, we will compare the parental and the double crossover type. On comparison, we notice that the C gene does not match in the parental and the double crossover type. Thus, the C gene is present in the center of gene A and B. So, the actual gene order is A, C and B. The third step is to determine single crossover between the genes. Considering this gene order A, C, B, we will do a single crossover between the two parental type between genes A and C. The recombinants obtained by this cross will be capital A, small b, small c, and small a, capital C, capital B. Now, we need to compare this recombinant with the table in the question. If we rearrange our recombinants, we have one capital A and small bc, and small a and capital bc. On comparing with the table, we find two recombinants that are satisfying the recombinant that we have obtained. So these two are single crossover between genes A and C. So naturally, the remaining two genotypes are obtained by a single crossover between genes C and B. But you can do a crossover yourself and check. The fourth step is to determine the distance between the genes. To determine the distance between genes A and C, we need to add the sum of the single crossover between gene AC and the double crossover progenies divided by the total number of progenies into 100, which gives us 17.9 centimorgans. Similarly, the distance between gene C and B will be the sum of the single crossover between gene CB and the double crossover progeny divided by the total number of progenies into 100, which gives us 7 centimorgans. So the distance from gene A to C is 17.9 centimorgan and the distance between genes C to B is 7 centimorgans. So to summarize it, we first need to identify the parental and the double crossover type gametes. The parental type have the highest number of progenies and the double crossover type have the lowest number of progenies. Then we need to compare the parental and the double crossover type to find one uncommon gene which will be placed in the center to get the gene order. Next, we need to determine the single crossover genes by crossing over, and then finally we need to determine the distance between the genes using the formula. In this question, we are supposed to find the distance between the genes P and Q. Here, instead of capital and small letters, they have used the form of plus and no plus sign to differentiate the two gene forms. Now, when we look at these values, we understand that these values are not really helping us to decide which is the parental type and which is the double crossover type. We cannot have four parental and four double crossover type. So, we cannot use our approach that we had been following. We need to use an alternative approach to solve this problem. What we need to understand is when crossing over occurs between the two genes, the two gene forms will not be together. One gene form is capital, so the other gene form is small. Similarly, in other questions, it can be written as plus or minus as the two gene forms, or plus or nothing as the two gene forms. Now, let us consider the single crossover between genes A and B. Over here, the crossing over is happening between genes A and B. You can see that in the parental type, both A and B are in the same form, in the capital form in one parent and in the small form in the other parent. However, in the recombinants, you can see that AB are not in the same form. One recombinant has capital A, small b, the other recombinant has small a and capital B. Similarly, it happens when the single crossover occurs between genes B and C. The genes B and C are not in the same form in the recombinants. In case of a double crossover, genes AB and genes BC cannot be in the same form in the recombinants. So here you can see genes AB, they are not in the same form, and even genes BC are not in the same form, which means that these recombinants occurred due to the double crossover. So this is how we can identify the recombinants of a single crossover or a double crossover. We need to find the distance between genes P and gene R. The formula for finding this is the sum of the single crossovers between genes PR plus the double crossovers upon the total into 100. So, we know if crossing over is happening between genes P and R, they will not be in the same form. So, here we'll look at the progenies, genotypes, and we will try to find out the single crossover and double crossover types. In this case, both are in the same form. Even in this case, R and P are in the same plus form. However, in this condition, they are not in the same form. P is not having a sign and R is having a plus sign. Similarly, we find out all the four conditions in which P and R are not in the same form, and we will consider those as our single crossovers and our double crossover. We know that double crossover have the least progeny, so we assume that these are the double crossovers. We will just put these values in the formula and we will get 49.5 centimorgans as the distance between genes P and R. If this video was helpful, then please like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to leave us your valuable comments. Thank you.